need to throw a 12 here. Ugh, I have a feeling this is going to be the final for this chapter, so I can't wait. Might as well get started. Who are you? Move over. Who's in charge here? Several cars arrive, and some guys come out of them. They're not guys from the Okunomiya station. One of the guys is wearing a suit despite the hot weather. He approaches me, pushing Kuma Guy aside. Hey, look who is here. Good to see you again, Otaka. Otaka? From the prefectural headquarters. Let's go with that. Watch your mouth. I'm ranked much higher than you now. You don't address me with Kun. Asshole. Can I help you with something, Otaka-kun? I'm rather busy right now. You aren't thinking about taking over this case, are you? Who approved it? I did, Oishi. Chief? Taketsugi has informed me of the situation. He also told me that you started all of this. You can go now. Let the troops take over.
The troops? Otaka, you aren't going to storm the building, are you?
I understand the risk, but we don't have any time left before the bomb goes off. You've wasted too much time. We are here to take care of the mess you left behind. You just step back. Oh god, this isn't going to end well. When the chief and the guy from the prefectural headquarters give me an order, I can't say anything.
Oishi, who the heck is he?
That's Otaka. Long time ago, he was showing off even though he was a bad mahjong player. So I taught him a lesson. Or maybe he's still holding a grudge from when I knocked him unconscious in a kendo tournament. Obviously, we don't get along. Oishi, give me your most up-to-date information.
Are you serious about storming the school? We're about to settle this thing peacefully with sleeping pills. What are you trying to do?
It's too late for that. If we had another hour, that would be possible. But now a special unit from the prefectural police department will move in. Your unit will be their backup.
Chief, you know what's going on, don't you? That classroom is a huge bomb now, but the classroom isn't the bomb we're scared about. It's the suspect, Ryugu Rena. We finally calmed her down and found a way to settle this peacefully. We're about to get that operation started. I know we only have about 10 minutes, but I'll make sure this works. I'll do the negotiation. If it doesn't work, I'll be blown up. You can all just watch it and say I told you so, okay?
Oishi, the special unit from the prefectural police department isn't just another unit. You've heard about the second troop, haven't you?
What is it, Oishi? Is the second troop that famous? Do you remember the Japanese Red Army's Dhaka incident about 5 years ago?
Nope.
I've heard that special counter-hijacking units were organized in Tokyo and Osaka after that incident.
Yep, never heard of it.
So they really do exist.
But why would Osaka's special unit be here?
Hokuta simply smiles proudly.
We just happened to hold a training session with your prefectural police unit here. We requested to help.
Ha ha ha, you haven't changed, have you? You have a bad habit of exaggerating things.
The unit members come out of the vehicles one after another and take position. They don't move like policemen. Well, yeah, they probably move in formation and all that bullshit.
Hotaka, are you going to have a gunfight at the school? One shot is all it'll take to trigger an explosion.
Don't worry, they won't use firearms. They're using riot shields and gas guns. They spout out tear gas with high pressure. There will be no problem.
Yeah, okay, buddy. You're an idiot.
Wow, I never knew about those convenient water guns. By the way, can that toy reach the classroom from across the school ground?
You don't need to worry about that. You just move over and let us do our job.
As I lift my arms exaggeratedly, my arm accidentally touches the car horn and it honks.
Of course, I did it on purpose.
I'm trying to get Miyabara Keiichi's attention.
Of course! I just hope Miyabara heard it.
What are you gonna tell him?
They're probably thinking about breaking one of the windows with a grenade and then shooting in a tear gas bullet. They don't know how serious Ryugu Rena is. She's dead serious. Even the noise of a breaking window could drive her over the edge.
Oh, she'd set that fucker on fire. Oh, it's over. You're fucked.
and I'm gonna be pissed. Are you saying that the special unit can't suppress her? Of course not. That's why we've been so careful. Ryuga Rena's intentions has been to die all along. A raid doesn't work on people who don't care about dying. We only have Mayabara now. Oishi. Here he is. Hello, this is Oishi. If you can hear me, please cough. This is an emergency. Please listen. I have a feeling it's not good news. Thanks, Keiichi. Unfortunately, you're right. The prefectural police is getting involved. They're trying to ruin everything we've set up so far. There's a special unit about to break in. Hey, the reason I haven't used my spray is because that won't stop her from igniting the gas. A raid can't work. The prefectural police don't understand that Ryugu is prepared to die. You're assuming the lighter is just a threat and that she isn't really going to ignite the gas. Oh my god. Do they honestly have they never actually been in this kind of situation before? The hell. Always assume their threat is serious. Never underestimate them. They'll break in within 5 minutes or so. Please take the lighter from Ryugu Rena before they move in. Is that in addition to your order to do something with the time bomb? Yes, that's right. You've got to be kidding me. You want me to take the lighter from Rena and do something about the time bomb with two within 5 minutes? Oh my god. You're the only one we can count on. You're our only hope. Please. How is it, Satoko? Can you think of something? I just want to check the hallway on the first floor. Whether it's there or not. Knowing Rena's patterns, if it was on the first floor, it would be there. And if it was on the second floor, it would be there. I just have to check it to see if there's a cord in the hallway on the first floor, right? It should be there. If Rena was in the normal state of mind, I would know for sure. But with her being like this, I really can't figure out how her thought pattern now. Okay, I'll do something. We don't even have time to think about it. I'll look into those two choices myself. I don't want another tragedy. Demons in hell, I bet you are just waiting for an amusing ending to unfold while eating some popcorn. I could use some popcorn right now, actually. I won't let that happen. I'm going to change everything. And I'm going to make you pick up some popcorn off the floor. Yeah, piece of shit. Don't drop it. I talk to Rena as she continues on with her story about aliens. Eh? What is it? What's the matter, Keiichi? Hey, didn't you hear something just now?
Nope. Huh? Lights the lighter. Fuck. Wrong.
Rena becomes quiet and looks around. Rena is totally suspicious about everything now. Once she becomes worried, she can't ignore that. Really? Are you sure, Keiichi? Yeah. I'm sure I heard something. I know she would check it herself. But she really can't leave for something like that. That means she has to ask me to check it for her. Rena must be thinking the same thing. Keiichi, can you go check? Rena gives me an order with a fake smile on her lips. Yeah, okay. Running. Rena watches me go out to the hallway. Then she speaks to me. Don't make me angry. Okay? Trust me. I'm your friend. Yeah, I trust you. I trust you, so don't betray me. Okay? When I'm freed from Rena, I look for a cord in a hurry. I don't even have 5 minutes. The teacher's office should have the most outlets. I head to the teacher's office. Shit, where are the outlets? The outlets aren't always near the entrances, unlike the light switches. Damn it, why does the clock in the teacher's office make such a loud ticking noise? Don't worry, Keiichi will find it. Rena would, if I were Rena. If Rena was even more suspicious than usual, where would she set the trap? A trap expert like me should be able to figure this out.
I have no idea. I assume an adjacent room. That's the easiest place to put it. You're not going to put it in the opposite side of the building.
What is this? I see a plug being plugged into the unit under the principal's desk, and I see a cord extending under the door to the guest room. Unplugging it. There shouldn't be any reason why a cord has to be extended to the next room. The guest room should have an outlet too. I walk to the guest room silently and open the door. Squeak. The door squeaks as I crack it open a little. I poke my head into the guest room. I see the suspicious cord crossing the guest room and extending under the door to the hallway. I follow the cord through the guest room. I open the door to the hallway. The cord is extending to the storage. The storage holds some cleaning chemicals. I can smell them from here. The cord is extending into the storage. I open the door carefully and turn the light on. The cord is attached to an extension cord. And there's an alarm clock that doesn't fit in the storage. Unplugging. I found it. The time bomb. So all I have to do is unplug this cord. I pick up the alarm clock. This looks like a normal alarm clock. Actually, it is a normal alarm clock. I remember Kumagai calling it a kitchen timer. He said it's a bit like an alarm clock. But this is not a bit like an alarm clock. This is an alarm clock. But don't alarm clocks use batteries? This alarm clock is a battery-operated one, too. I look at the extension cord, and there's nothing plugged in. Oh my god, she has a fuck ton of decoys. Fuck. What? What's the extension cord for? Why is this extending all the way from the teacher's office? No, Keiichi. Run. Whoever. Satoko? That's not it. You've been tricked. I see a black shadow covering me. Oh, good god. I feel my body freeze. It's so frozen, I feel like it's about to crack. I turn around slowly. I see someone holding a hatchet up high. Fuck. Game over. I drop the alarm clock. It makes a noise as it hits the ground. Why did you follow the extension cord, and why did you have the alarm clock in your hand? Why? All the cells in my body are frozen. Oh, I'd be running. I'd be running away. This was Rena's trap. No shit. Rena is suspicious about everyone, including me. She thought there was someone connected to the people outside all along. This was a trap to lure that person out. Only the people outside know about the time bomb. I was told about the whole thing, yet I followed the extension cord and picked up the alarm clock. How stupid of me. Wait, Rena. I trusted you, Keiichi. How could you? Rena hit me with the backside of the hatchet earlier, and it fucking hurt. It was painful, but it didn't kill me. Oh, yeah, you're standing here. But this time she's holding the hatchet the right way. Oh, good god. It wouldn't just crack my forehead. It would go straight through it. It would split open my head. Running. Rena lifts the hatchet mercilessly. She moves slowly as if everything is in slow motion. She almost looks holy. No, not really. Probably more like a demon at this point. Maybe it really is holy. No, it's probably not. In the sense that I'm praying. Praying? What am I praying for? Then she misses. Am I praying for my life? I would be. Ah! I don't know what happened. I don't know either. Rika jumps onto Rena from behind. Nice music, though. I don't know what kind of weapon Rika used, but Rena keeps moaning. It clearly hurt. Pepper spray. That brings me back to reality. I can't just watch them. Oh, no, I'm taking that hatchet. That's what I would take immediately. Grabbing it. Bye. If that lighter's on the ground, I'm grabbing that, too. I have to get the lighter from Rena. There you go. Ah! Don't think you can defend yourself. Rena knows I'm after the lighter. She doesn't open her fingers. Rika's grabbing onto Rena's arms with the hatchet. Thank you. I want to tell her to run, but thanks to Rika, I can use my hands to get the lighter. Oh, I would be like stepping on her throat to get that thing out of her grasp, if not just breaking her neck. And saying, yeah, good night. Pop. Bye. Ah! The lighter flies out of Rena's hand. Mine. It hits the wall in the hallway and falls down onto the floor. Mine. I pick it up. Thank God. I then quickly run to a window, open the windows, and throw it out. Rena shakes off Rika at the same time. Bye. Keiichi. I know, I figured it out. Okay, whatever. I don't know who's talking anymore. Fuck it. I hear Satoko screaming from the classroom. Satoko figured out where Rena hid the time bomb. I want to catch Rena, but I don't have the time for that. I have to do something about the time bomb instead of Rena. Keiichi, hurry up and go back to Satoko. Rika has her arms up to stop Rena. Why can't she just yell where it is? Hello? I don't want to have to waste time to go back to the classroom. She tells me, and then I have to go back, wherever it is. Just tell me now. I just scream. What are you doing? Just run! Keiichi, this isn't the first time I've done this for you. Don't you remember?
Nope.
Huh? If I tried a little harder the previous time, you could have made it. So this time you're going to make it. Just go.
I don't know what Rika is talking about, so I just go. But there's one thing I do know. Just like Rena and Mion were ready to give up their lives for her friends, and as I'm willing to give up my own life for my friend, Rika is prepared to. Therefore, telling Rika to run is like telling her she isn't a friend. So I depend on my friend Rika.
Thank you, Rika. Keiichi, we don't have much time left.
I run to the classroom. You could have just yelled where it is.
As soon as Rika hears Keiichi's footsteps reach the classroom, she sighs in relief. Rena's black shadow comes closer to Rika.
Oh, you're fucking dead.
That's great. This isn't a club activity, you know. He'll be killed for real. He'll be killed by an angry Rena. You're not afraid of me, are you? That's great, Rika.
Rika grabbed a mop as she ran from the storage. She picks it up and holds it upside down like a spear. Too bad it's not sharpened and just spear her throat open.
Rika stands tells Rena that she is ready to fight.
Rika doesn't look like a little girl anymore. She looks so brave that Rena is even startled by it. Yeah, I still think a hatchet's going straight through that mop.
Boy, you're brave. You aren't afraid of being killed, huh?
Huh? Rika smiles sarcastically. Rika usually never smiles this way.
Do you really think I would be afraid of death? I've experienced several hundred deaths in the past. Why should I be afraid of it now?
Holy fucking shit. It is Groundhog Day. Oh god, that would suck. Oof. Several hundred deaths? Oof. Ooh, that sucks. That's unfortunate. That is unfortunate for you. Ooh.
You aren't Rika, are you? You're the one whom I met that night. Come out, alien. Where's the real Rika?
Oh, good god.
The real Rika? She's right here. Nipa? Huh. That sneering expression really is Rika's. I get it. Oyashiro-sama is an alien. The Furude family descended from her, therefore you are a descendant of aliens. I'll crack open your head and drag out all the parasites in your brain.
Rena lifts up her hatchet and charges at Rika with a scream.
Huh. One swing is all I need to smash your head.
Rena looks like a beast charging towards his prey. Rika takes a step backwards and lowers her body to intercept. She doesn't have any hesitation.
I only need just a minute, that's plenty. I'll play with you. Come on, hatchet girl.
Meanwhile,
don't you get it, Keiichi? All the hints and answers were already there this morning.
Calm down, Satoko. Explain more slowly so I can understand.
You only have a finite amount of time, Keiichi. Get the fuck over it. I don't care about the backstory. Just tell me where it is.
That's all I care about.
What are you trying to say?
It was so easy.
Just remember. Hey, something stinks today. Close the window.
Silly, it'll be hotter in here if we close the windows.
We've been smelling gasoline coming from the outside. There were no Forest Service people in the office, so they weren't doing any work today. So they didn't create the smell. In other words, this was a smell of gasoline Rena prepared.
I figured she was just going to burn down the school. With everyone inside. I didn't think she'd actually set a bomb. I thought she was just gonna burn it down and say fuck it. Rena hid the gasoline near the classroom. She had it in a plastic container. You can't smell gasoline in a plastic container. In other words, she had more gasoline ready than the container she prepared to scatter in the classroom. Where was the smell coming from? Was it coming from outside? Vaporized gasoline is heavier than air. It stinks. There was another hint. What? Our ball is missing. You hit it again, didn't you, Hojo? Why would I hide such a stupid thing? If I was going to hide something, I'd hide something better than that. Kids who love to play with their ball never lose it. It should have been in the same place. But it was gone. That means Rena used it for something. The gasoline is coming from above. A ball is missing. It's stuffed. Rena blocked the drain with the ball and poured gasoline in the drain canal.
What the fu- okay. Sure.
Where? On the roof of the second floor. The drain canal extends along the roof of the on the second floor and comes straight down and drains out to the ground. If it's plugged and filled with gasoline, it's like a huge Molotov cocktail that extends from the ground to the roof on the second floor. Furthermore, the drain canal runs by the classroom windows. If the canal explodes, the classroom will explode too. And close enough. I said an adjacent room. A drain pipe that runs along the window is close enough. It's basically an adjacent room. Therefore, the time bomb is... I bet she used an extension cord from the second floor window. It's on the rooftop. I pick up a pair of scissors and cut Satoko's rope. Okay. By the way, how did Rika free herself from the ropes? I'm sorry, I'm not thin enough to untie it myself. I rub Satoko's head. Take care of the rest here. I'm going up to the rooftop. Oh, you better have taken those fucking scissors so you can just snap the cord. Then it's over. No time bomb, you have the lighter. Then you just kill Rena, everyone lives. You open all the windows, let it all slowly dissipate. And then try to get Mion out of there, which is going to be terrible. As I jump out from the classroom, Satoko stops me. Keiji, here! What is it? Something silver sails through the air. I catch it. It's a metal bat. Oh, I could have used this before. Which I told you what it... That's Nini's. Make sure you give it back to me, okay? Sure. Thanks, Satoko. When you could have probably just used that to beat the shit out of Rena... in the first place, but whatever. The metal bat fits right in my palm. I don't even feel its weight. This is great. The name Satoshi is written on the handle. This is the bat that belonged to Satoko's brother, Satoshi. Oh, hey, this is what I beat Rena's head in with. He was the victim of last year's tragedy. You and I are the same. I won't let another tragedy take place. This is a good luck gift from Satoshi. Let's destroy the demon's tragic script together. Let's go, Satoshi. As I try to run up the stairs, I hear a loud noise coming from the hallway out by the teacher's office. Ignoring it. I see Rika rolling on the floor. Damn, Rika. Good job. Damn it. If I were 5 years older. You're next, Keiichi. Wah!
Shit, I have to go. I have to get to the rooftop. Bye.
How did you figure it out? How did you? But I won't let you get up there. She looks unbelievably scary.
Actually, what you probably could do is just take like a 10-second detour, hit her in the side of the head with a bat, and start running.
She is ready to rip me apart if she catches me.
Sure, try me.
I jump up the stairs, skipping the steps. I turn the bug on in my pocket. I don't have time to put it in my ear, in an earphone. As Rena comes up the stairs, her foot gets caught on the jump rope. She falls, and then three buckets fall on her head. Ah, Satoko's trap. Ouch. Satoko, huh? Satoko leans against the wall and waves her index finger in a mocking gesture.
Oh, you're gonna fucking die. You're gonna get a hatchet right to the side of the head.
You were pretty good, but you are about 300 million light years too early to go up against a trap expert like me. Satoko, light years the distance.
Dumbass.
Smash, the fourth bucket hits Satoko's head. I continue up to the roof. Rena ignores Satoko and runs after me. Oh, guess not. You're not gonna die now.
Oh, Oishi, I did it. I got the lighter. I know where the time bomb is. It's on the roof in the drain canal. I'm headed over there right now. Oishi, is that it? Oishi grabs the pair of binoculars from the kumagai and looks at the rain gutter on the rooftop. There's an alarm clock sitting there. How didn't they So basically, had they actually looked around the surroundings, saw an alarm clock sitting up there, could have sent someone to shimmy up the roof and unplug it. The cord from the alarm clock is extending to the second floor window. It's so obvious, but they didn't even notice it until now. Jeez, you got... Have you ever dealt with a situation? Actually, no, they have dealt with the kidnapping situation. So, come on, guys. Come on. Sasuke is working hard to release her classmates' restraints. Don't spark anything. But she can't do anything about the U-shaped lock on Mion's neck. Is she the only one with it? I'm gonna be so fucking pissed if she's the only one to die. I'll be really pissed. I'll be livid. Everyone, just run. Forget about me. Oh my god. I swear to fucking god. I'll be pissed. Hey, that doesn't sound like Mion. Why don't you act like the club leader, even in a situation like this? All you have to do is give an order as the leader to undo this lock, okay? Satoko reaches for the back of her collar and produces a bent hairpin. Oh, please unlock it, please, to god. If she's the only one to die, I'm gonna be so fucking pissed. You don't understand. Satoko opens the window, climbs onto the windowsill, and faces the U-shaped lock that's restraining Mio. Everyone, open the curtains in the windows, then run. Class rep, what about Mayabara? The police will help Keichon. You all run out as soon as possible. Huh? Did you unlock it already? To me, this type of lock is child's play. Oh my god, thank god. Thank god. Now just kill Rena. That's all that needs to happen. The binoculars are trained on the classroom. All the curtains are open, as well as the windows. All the children are running out to the school ground. I'm getting the fuck out of here! Oishi pushes Otaka aside, grabs the radio and screams into it. All units, go! Go, go! Secure the hostages! The suspect is going up to the second floor, running after one of the hostages. Hey, what are you doing? Otaka tries to grab the radio from Oishi. Kumagai steps in. Oishi, give me back the radio. Look! There's a noise and Otaka crumbles down on the floor, convulsing. Oops, sorry. Guess my knee happened to hit your balls. Oh my god. The classroom is still filled with gasoline. Be very careful. You're forbidden from using any gas shells or flare shells. Again, do not use gas shells or flare shells. It'll explode. From the support unit to HQ, we secured 24 hostages. One is injured. This is the shock unit. We are trying to take control of the first floor. We've got a problem. The electric room is locked. We can't go in. They can't go in? Can't they break the door? It's locked directly opposite from the classroom. The smell of gasoline is strong in here. We may ignite the gas when breaking the door. We'll wait for further orders. Cut off the main city power. There has to be... Get authorized from like the grid and just shut down this section. Or there's has to be an outside meter. Or at least an outside source of electricity that you can shut off. Shit. We could have just turned the power off. Forget the electric room. Go suppress the second floor. Roger. Shock unit. Alpha. Go, go, go. Otaka. What were you going to do if you failed to secure the electric room? That is, that's what the special unit was for. Oh boy. I guess we just have to unplug the clock. From snipe unit to HQ, I see a male hostage on the rooftop on the first floor. Oishi, that's Mayabara. Give me the speaker. Mayabara, the power source for the clock is in the back room of the second floor. I shake my head repeatedly. I can't do that. Rin's coming after me. I can't do what I want to do. What else can I do? Unplug it? The only way is to go up to the roof of the second floor and get the clock. Mayabara, continue up the roof of the second floor. I'll direct you. Oishi is telling me to go farther up. Sachiko only told me it's on the rooftop of the second floor. She didn't tell me where it is exactly. She only said it was in the drain canal. But maybe Oishi found it with his binoculars. Well, obviously it's going to be on the same side the classroom is. So that's what I would be gunning for. I would just run along the entire side looking for it. I put my foot on the railing of the veranda and run up to the rooftop of the second floor. I never felt so light. I feel like I could lift myself with just two or three fingers. That's called adrenaline. That's it, keep going. The furthest end of the rail gutter. You only have 30 seconds. Huh? 30 seconds will be more than plenty. I can get there in half that time. There, is that it? Yeah, that's it. From the snipe unit to HQ. I see the suspect on the rooftop on the first floor. Ah, I wish you could fire, but you're using live ammo, right? It's not tear gas or anything, is it? No, it's live ammunition. Take this shot. Fuck it. Put her down. Bam! Drop her. Use those in the military. The Japanese police don't need those. Maibara. She's after you. Hurry. She'll be there soon. How many more seconds do I have? Who cares? Ah. I slide down the roof and grab the time bomb that's sitting on the drain canal, which is filled with gasoline. There's a cord with copper line attached to it. This was supposed to create sparks and create an explosion. The hands on the clock keep moving, and the second hand is trying to reach the minute hand. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. I throw it down to the ground. I hear a delayed noise. Did I do it? Shock unit to HQ. The time bomb has been stopped. Yes! Oishi, we did it. We did it. Yeah. Maibara, good job. Now Renna's gonna chop you to pieces. Keiichi. Keiichi made me nervous. It's uncomfortable not to have some extra time, you know? Not only policemen, but the children who are on their way to ambulances raised their voices in a cheer. Oishi, there's a message from the fire department. The scene is still dangerous. Order all units to retreat immediately. But the time bomb is gone. Yeah, it still can explode due to a shock. Or a spark. Although the ignition device is gone, it's still extremely dangerous. The lives of the shock troops may be in danger. Damn! What about Maibara on the rooftop? Can you jump off? Oishi, according to the map, there's a flower bed by the school building. We'll tell him to jump there. Oishi, to all units. Stop the operation. Fall back immediately. Fall back. Take the fucking shot already. Take your head off. Roger, Alpha. Roger, Beta. Fall back. Fall back. Can you hear me, Maibara? Also, Ryugu. It's too dangerous to stay there. It may explode at any minute. There's a flower bed by the school building. Jump down there. A flower bed? Damn it. I can't see it from here. But it doesn't sound like I have enough time to be looking for it. I see a white hand on the edge of the roof. Then I see Renna's head. Oh, I'm bashing that fucker down. Fucking whack-a-mole style here. Bam! Right, she starts to get up on the roof. Just hit her right in the crown of the head. Stay the fuck down. Renna slowly crawls up to the roof. I wait for her. Oh, I'd be... Other way, please. I never thought you would find it. Everything was for nothing. Rina scratches her throat. Can you just claw your own fucking throat out already? The bandages on her throat come off, and her throat starts to bleed. Can you please don't bleed on me, please? It's game over, Rina. We're comfortable confronting each other on the roof of the second floor. This is it. The club's real fight activity is over. Rina was glaring at me with hatred at first. But maybe because she has already given up, she starts smiling wickedly. I hear the chorus of the Higurashi in the background, as if they are praising our brave fight. But I don't think we are at that point yet. Yeah, if it was a board game, you'd have reached a goal and you'd win. But this isn't a game. So this isn't a goal. This is a dead end. Shit, you don't give up, do you? Erna, you are strong. You never give up. You fight until the very end. Oh, I'd be fight. If I have to fight her, I'm kicking her off the fucking roof. You also you keep believing until the very end. Praising me like that doesn't make me happy now. You ruined everything that I planned at the risk of my life, Keiichi. I was simply trying to protect humans from aliens. You've ruined it. If humans perish, it's your fault, Keiichi. That will be recorded in history. Actually, if humans all perish, there's no history left. So, I won't be recorded in history. I don't mean to laugh, but I can't help it. Oh, I'd be laughing at her. My name will be in the history books of aliens. Named as the one who destroyed humans. Wow, that sounds cool. Actually, I would make fun of her and say, oh, am I a legend among the aliens? Oh, that would be dope. They'll name cities after me. Monuments in my honor. I'd be fucking with her. It's like, why not? Rena, no matter what you say, I will win this game. I've already won and you just don't want to admit it, that's all. Yeah, maybe you're right. But maybe that's not how it works. A game doesn't end when there's a winner. It ends when there's a loser. That means, for me, to win isn't enough. Hmm? What do you mean? I have to make sure you lose. I pat my shoulder with the metal bat, gesturing for Rena to come at me. I'm going to make you understand that you lost. I won't run or hide. You better beat her into submission, Keiichi. I will not be happy until you crush her. Do you know why? According to our club regulation, we don't run her from our enemy. I'll prove to you that you've already lost, Rena. Hmm? Are you ready? Parasites and aliens? How stupid. Who would believe in such things nowadays? I can only laugh. Ha ha ha. You've never believed me in the first place. You pretended that you did. How dare you deceive me? I won't forgive you. I'll never forgive you. Yeah, okay, whatever. I don't care if you believe in those things. But I would never believe in such stupid things. If I have to believe in something stupid, I'd rather believe in the buried treasures of the Tokugawa Shogunate. But if you still want me to believe in it, don't you remember our club rules? Whoever wins is right. There you go. Rena and I grin at each other, and as we go around in circles on the rooftop, we both check the distance between us. If you can take me down, I will believe in your alien stories. I'll perform a mysterious dance every morning and night to call for UFOs and attend cattle mutilations. But Rena, if I take you down, then I want you to be ready. I don't think you need to think even farther. You will never defeat me. Hey, you still have that mace, Keiichi. You can still use it.
I would. Because you're going to have to be in hand-to-hand combat range with a bat. You just hit her with it and then just start beating the shit out of her with a baseball bat.
Rena comes at me with a heavy strike. I catch it easily with the metal bat. I think there are some sparks. It's finally getting interesting. Oh my god, they're going to set off the fucking building exploding, aren't they? Oh my god. Hey, maybe you shouldn't say that yet. You may be wrong, you know. While going through some fierce battles in our club activities, I've learned something. I've learned about myself. Now I know what I need to bring out my strongest power.
Yeah, what I need is to make sure Mion is safe. That's what I need. Strongest power activated.
Really? I wonder what it is. I wonder. Rena, your hatchet can be a powerful weapon, but my battle bat is as powerful as your hatchet. I don't know about that. Sure, it doesn't have a blade, but it reaches farther and it's easy to handle.
True.
But again, it's not as deadly as a hatchet. Because she gets one hit on you, a good hit, you're done.
You're done.
Unless you want to sacrifice like part of your arm. Like, hopefully it gets, like, stuck in your arm if she didn't, like, get all the way through your bone. Get stuck a little bit. Then you just use your other hand and start beating the shit out of her with it. So you can sacrifice parts. It's gonna hurt like a bitch. But I won't go for a defensive battle. I'm going to battle you face to face, and I'm going to defeat you. Oh, this is an easy one where a defensive battle wins. Easily. Because you just want to tire her out. And then once you tire her out, you easily beat her. I'm sure I'm stronger than you physically, but you're better bringing out your hidden abilities, Rena.
In other words, we are equally powerful. This is great. I don't need to hold back. So what are you going to do after you take me down? Here, here, here. I think I have the upper hand.
Huh?
I'm just warming up. Just wait. What should I do with you after I take you down? We're both betting so many coins and chips.
Go all in. Prepare to pay a big amount.
Are you counting your chickens before they hatch? Your bluff is so pathetic.
You don't get it, do you?
What? My power increases as my reward gets bigger, don't you know? Let's see. You'll be my personal maid. Starting from the moment I wake up until I go to sleep at night, you'll serve me all day every day. Your costume will change every day thanks to the manager's full support. Wow, until I go to sleep at night? Oh my, I won't let you go to sleep tonight. Yeah, except she's going to jail. And, you know, that whole issue. How about that? Yeah, she's not gonna be in Hinami's all for much longer. After, you know, threatening all this fucking terrible shit. It's not a joke anymore.
That's so like you, Keiichi. No, thank you. Actually, I'll win and you'll be my servant.
You'll probably kill yourself by that point. We both laugh like crazy people as we strike at each other. It's strange that this is getting more and more fun. Yeah, I don't think you've realized you're still over a building that can explode. Ren and I are trying to kill each other, yet we're having fun. Sparks are flying, we could get seriously injured. If we fall off the roof, we'll break our bones, yet this is so much fun. That's why I would have kicked her off the roof. Especially if she lands on her back, there's a really high probability she breaks her back. She's not getting back up anytime soon. I was mourning and crying all day today while Rena scared me. How did all that turn into this? That means we can't be serious even if we try. Even with sparks flying, we can only goof around.
Too bad. That's not me. I like being elegant and graceful. You just have fun goofing around by yourself, Keiichi.
Rena's strike comes from a strange angle, but I managed to deflect it. Wow. Actually, thank God it's not a wood baseball bat. Because that would have been really ineffective against a hatchet.
That's too weak, you're done. Finally, I'm all warmed up. This is just a warm-up, right?
Huh?
Fool, this isn't even a warm-up.
This is like taking a walk.
Hey, you're all sweaty. Instead of sweat, you will be covered in your own blood.
Mayabara, jump off. Come on, jump.
Isn't he even listening?
He's so excited he doesn't even hear anything.
Oishi.
Sorry. What is it?
What do you mean, what is it? We have to figure out a way to rescue him.
Oishi can't figure out why he was distracted, considering how serious the situation is. He was engrossed in watching the two of them fight with the sunset behind them. But Oishi isn't the only one. Everyone is captivated by their battle on the rooftop. That's when a sudden loud voice breaks the silence.
Mayabara, hang in there! Careful, don't fall!
The students who are about to climb onto the ambulance are cheering him on. Mion has bandages on her head, but she is captivated by Ren and Keiji's fight even as she gets up from the stretcher. The happy days were supposed to shatter due to the series of misunderstandings. They're supposed to be irretrievable. God, I wish I could read. But? What? Why? Why do I feel this way? This is such a close game. But a standoff isn't fun. Ren and I kick at each other with perfect timing, increasing the distance between us.
Hey, this is getting really fun.
How is it, Rena? Isn't this the best? Oh, I would have had this thing wrapped up. Actually, no, I said play the long con defensive battle, where you just wear her out. You just bide your time. Take it to the 8th round and then just beat the shit out of her.
I've been having fun since the very beginning. But it'll be even more fun to split open your head, Keiichi. Won't it?
Wow, that's dangerous. Here. Come back over here. Let's use more space.
Something like this doesn't happen often. Let's enjoy it as much as we can. This is a great picture. Look, there's a beautiful moon behind us. The breeze feels great. This is such a fantastic scene. Two people are fighting on the rooftop of the school building with the moon behind them. It's almost unbelievable. This is a mysterious and fantastical scene. All the policemen and children look at them from a distance. They're completely entranced. Everyone is thinking the same thing, but nobody says anything. Why are they having so much fun? To be so passionate in a breeze like this. This reminds me of the Watanagashi Festival. I don't like to enjoy the cool of the evening quietly. When the moon comes up, I can't control myself. All the club members went crazy on the night of Watanagashi. The village leader scolded us at the end, but we laughed at each other and promised to do the same thing again next year. Except Verena probably won't be with us.
Going crazy under the moon, huh? That sounds cool, doesn't it? Maybe we are already crazy under the moon.
Yeah, I agree. We're having fun trying to kill each other. We must be mad already. This must be what insanity is like. Oh no, you could probably just ask Rena how she's feeling right now.
Some people say the moon has the power to arouse people.
Sure. Maybe that's true, and maybe it's not. One thing that's for sure is that even if we're a new moon tonight, we would still be this passionate.
As our surroundings get darker, the sparks we create look like fireflies.
Hey, isn't there gasoline in the drain canal right by us?
Yes.
Who cares? If an explosion happens, it happens.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Get the fuck out of here, Keiichi.
I want to live. I guess he doesn't. I wonder if he's borderline suicidal at times. I want to live. So I don't do anything. I wouldn't do anything stupid to unpurposely shorten my life.
Hey, what are you doing? Is your hand getting too sweaty to hold the bat? Why don't you take a break and dry your hand? I'll split your head open while you do that, though.
That's great.
Doesn't your skirt cling onto your legs? You can take it off if you want.
I'll just watch you instead of attacking you.
Really? I'll smack your head while you're looking at my legs.
It's so much fun, huh, Rena?
Yep, it sure is.
I'd be killing her, but whatever. We fly, we dance, we strike, we laugh.
We step back once in a while to pause, and then charge at each other and let the sparks fly. We aim at each other as we go around in circles on the rooftop of the school, our special stage. Rena and I are all sweaty, but we aren't exhausted. The beads of sweat rolling down my body are tickling me. We respond to each other with violent attacks. There's no advantage or disadvantage. There's no exultation of victory or anger of defeat. This battle with Rena in itself is what's fun.
Yeah, minus that she's trying to kill you.
This is like a dance. This is a dance that I can't dance by myself. This is a dance that I can only dance with someone who is equally powerful. Didn't you think the same thing I did when we had the club activity day with the whole class? We had the duel with water guns.
Yeah, I did.
We wanted to fight like this again. As we think that way on the rooftop, the classmates must have thought the same thing. Our fight is so pure and passionate, and everyone thinks the same thing. We want to join them. It was the same then. We used water guns, but we did the same thing.
But this is far more fun. I don't have to worry about how much water I have left in my gun.
Yeah, we can't create sparks with water guns either.
We couldn't strike at each other like this either.
We both breathe hard, waiting for the right time to take our step. and we grin at each other. This is exactly what I said then, but I'm going to say it again. Okay then, I'll respond just the same. We grin at each other. This is so fun. I don't even want it to end in this. Don't hate me if you lose. No, I won't. I'd hate myself for ending this game. But I know I wouldn't be the one to cry in the end. I don't know what to do. I don't know about that. Your feet are getting weak, as if they're made of straw. Shut up. Ugh. Everyone is captivated by the fight. Everyone is swept up in the fight. We both have weapons. I'm waiting for the spark to explode the building. Everyone dies in a horrible, gruesome death. I'm waiting for it, honestly. The weapons deadly enough to seriously hurt each other. To kill each other. Not hurt, kill. But we are both perfectly equal and neither of us hit the other yet. Why do they look so happy? This is just crazy. All the people are just watching this fight on the rooftop with the beautiful moon as a backdrop. Take the shot. Fuck it. End this thing. Hit her right in the fucking kneecap. End it. See, he should have just taken the shot. Oh, I have a clear visual of the target. Take the shot. Fuck it. Not even the police can stop them. It's impossible. This fight is impossible. Keiji, try to stay in the middle of the roof. Use the height to your advantage. Satsuko and the classmates cheer Keiji on, but there are some who are cheering for Rena too. Oh, what the fuck, guys? She just wanted to kill you. To them, this is no longer a deadly fight. What the fuck is wrong with you guys? Her way, you'd all be dead now. Get the fuck out of here. Whoever they are needs to go into, like, mental evaluations. For Stockholm Syndrome. This is simply the second round of that water gun fight. A club activity is a club activity, and a game is a game. This isn't a game. As much as you want it to be a game, it's not a game. This is just the second round, so nobody will die. They have real weapons, though. But nobody thinks they would get hurt. Yeah, okay. Yeah, Keiji slips. She's taking his head off. Rika isn't cheering. She's just looking up to the rooftop. I've never seen anything like this, Rika thinks. She thinks Keiji can win. Nah, he's probably gonna lose. Everyone dies. Not against Rena, though. Rika thinks Keiji can destroy the walls of the Maze of Tragedies that has no exit. What are the snipers doing? The suspect is trying to harm the hostage. Fire immediately! As Okata yells into the radio, Mion screams. No! Don't shoot Rena! Rena isn't crazy anymore. She isn't who she was earlier. This is a different Rena. So please don't shoot her. God fucking... Mion, stop it! No! I had my convictions. Stop it. What do you mean she's different? Look! She's swinging that weapon. She's trying to kill him. Unless we shoot her down, the hostage is in danger. No! Don't shoot at Rena. If you shoot Rena, Keijan will kill you for sure. I can guarantee it. Why would he kill me? They aren't trying to kill each other. They're just having fun creating sparks. Can't you see? And Keijan is talking to her. He's telling her that he is equal to her. That means she can trust him more than anyone. Keijan will wake Rena up. No, he is already waking her up. Rena's nightmare is almost over. Mion, I'll trust you, but whatever. I'm just saying, I think the easiest solution here is just... She needs to bite the bullet. Both literally and figuratively. Keiji, you're the best. I don't want to kill you. A world without you would be so boring. Huh, thanks for your compliment. I appreciate it. So what's going to happen to the world then, huh? Aren't aliens trying to invade it? You know, I feel like I don't even care about aliens or parasites anymore. If the world is going to perish, go ahead and perish. Who cares about the conspiracy of the three families? That's right, even if a meteor hits the Earth tomorrow. Nothing is more fun than this moment. She's still probably going to end up killing him. Hey, aren't you supposed to die tonight due to the poisoning? You sure don't look like you only have a few hours left to live. That's right, I completely forgot about that. I am supposed to rip out my throat and die tonight. Oh, it's like it was a placebo effect.
Hey, that's the scenario you came up with, don't forget. Go on, scratch your throat out once in a while at least. I know it doesn't itch anymore, does it? Of course it doesn't. That's because it's more fun than scratching your throat. What we are doing is a lot more fun. You're still going to prison. I wish this fun would never end. But my body is screaming. I'm breathing hard and I feel dizzy from lack of oxygen. My upper body feels as light as a piece of paper, and I feel as if even a slight breeze could take me away. This is so much fun, but I need to end this soon. This sadness is what I felt in that water gun fight. It was a tied match. I wonder what will happen this time. Who knows? But one thing is for sure.
What?
It was really fun.
Yeah, it was.
I jump backwards and slam the roof with the bat. The sound is as intense as a huge drum. The noise wakes up the people who are captivated by our fight. The silence comes back. The chorus of Higurashi fills the air.
Time to finish this. Kicks her off roof. Rena dies. End of story.
Okay, let's pause for a moment. Sure. Let's end with the next strike. We start to move slowly and increase the distance between us. Everyone realizes this fight is ending very soon. Okay, this is it. I'm gonna ask you one more time. What is it? Hey, you were betting something on this fight, right? Were you fighting for that?
I did.
Sorry, I forgot. Hey. Okay, listen carefully. If I win, you'll become my personal maid and serve me every day. You have to introduce me to others as your master.
The uniform better be cute.
Of course. There'll be a variety of uniforms ranging from old-fashioned ones to radical ones. They'll be custom-made, so they'll fit you perfectly. How about that?
My goodness. I don't intend to lose, but that sounds like fun.
If you win, Rena. I paused for a little. If you win, I will believe your stories. Rena was happy until just a moment ago, but she suddenly becomes expressionless. Aliens are invading the Earth and we have parasites in our brains. The Sonozaki family is pulling the strings. They research it secretly and aliens will be in control of the world starting tomorrow. I'll believe in that. Also, since you're dying tonight, I'll make sure you go peacefully, so don't worry.
It's not fun if I win, is it?
Your reward sounds a lot more fun, Keiichi.
Well, what can I do? You did all this because of what I just said, right?
Yeah, I guess. Sorry, I almost forgot.
Rena smiles sadly, but goes back to the expressionless face immediately. God, it's like your world sucks. I'm going to win no matter what. I want my personal maid.
Boo-hoo-hoo. It's not fun if I win.
Then do you want to change it? What do you want?
Finally, Rena smiles happily. The breeze dries our sweat. This feels good. We don't go crazy anymore, even with the moon out. We can finally enjoy this coolness of the evening. It would be so nice if we could lie down on our backs and just look at the moon. Rena speaks with a little smile.
I want the same reward as yours, Keiichi.
What? You want me to be your maid? That's something.
You don't have to be my maid, but the rest is the same. I want you to say good morning to me in the mornings and good night to me at night.
No thank you.
I want you to treat me well and let me have lots of fun. I guess, no matter who wins, we'll always be together.
Oh my good god, fuck off.
Keiichi, kill her already.
We'll be together, but who gets the special treatment is different.
Why am I doing this with someone I like so much?
I don't know. Why are we on the rooftop? Why did we even come up here in the first place?
I don't know. I forgot.
Maybe we're both airheads, and that's why we floated to the rooftop.
Yep, we are idiotic friends.
We're friends, all right.
Well, shall we get started? I don't want our bodies to cool down.
You're right. We better finish up before we cool down it completely.
Break her skull open, Keiichi. Do it. Do it.
We take our weapons and take our stances.
The final strike.
I almost suggested to stop this. I really did.
I shake my head slowly. No. We have to finish this.
otherwise this won't end. Our fight won't end. We must finish this. We have to end this.
Oh my god, that would be perfect, just to, like, a bullet goes straight through the side of her head. Blows out the side of the other half. It's like, oh shit. Well, that's one way to solve this fight. Oh, Keiichi, PTSD immediately. All the kids watching, oh, gone. Actually, they're already fucked mentally.
This isn't right. There's a possibility that no matter who wins or loses, there will be no reward. Even if that happens, don't hate the other. So I'm gonna tell you this now. What? This was fun. Yeah, I feel the same way. Rena, even if one of us dies, we'll see each other again. And when we do, we'll have fun in a normal way. We'll laugh together in a normal way. And we'll fall in love in a normal way. No, we won't. No.
I'm gonna veto that one real quick. As Keiichi's mental mind in here, the rational side, I'm gonna veto that one.
We won't doubt each other. We'll trust each other. We'll meet again, right? For sure, right?
Veto the falling in love with each other.
Yeah. Sure. Tears appear in Rena's eyes.
And I take advantage of that since she's temporarily slightly blinded, and I hit her in the side of the head, instantly killing her.
I notice I'm about to break down too.
Get the fuck over yourself, man.
Okay.
Are you ready?
There is no signal, but we take our steps at the same time. Our shadows jump in the moonlight. We were fighting so viciously earlier, but it seems if we are moving very slowly now. We look like a shadow play. Everyone is watching the shadows dance. Rena's shadow hits my metal bat violently. As a result, I let go of my bat.
Fuck.
Then my old bat bounces once on the roof and then rolls down to the school ground.
Fuck me. Thank God for this police baton. Because I'm gonna beat the shit out of you, Rena.
I've lost my weapon.
You're fucked. You're dead.
Here's Rena's chance. Of course she won't miss this chance. I'm down on the roof and Rena gets on top of me.
Well, it's been a great life. Sniper, please take the shot and save me.
Rena's knees are holding down my arms and there's no way for me to fight back. Mr. Sniper, please.
Please take the shot. Please.
The moon is split into halves. The shadow of Rena's hatchet is splitting the moon into halves. Mr. Sniper, please.
I don't care anymore.
This is it. Shit, that was good. I can't even pull my arms. Hey, Keiichi, this is it, right?
Mr. Sniper, take the shot. Take the shot.
No, not yet. Till you swing down the hatchet, it's not over. I don't want to.
Huh?
I don't want to. I don't want to.
Mr. Sniper, please take the shot. Take the shot while she's distracted.
Before she becomes resolved and shoves that thing down into my skull. Take the shot, please. Rena's arms are still up, but tears are pouring down from her eyes. What happened? What went wrong? I loved everyone, and I trusted everyone. When did I start to doubt them?
Take the shot.
I don't know why I'm doing this to you. I don't know. Why? Why am I doing this to people I love so much?
Take the shot.
You realized it. You realized it in this world. I can't believe myself. I was having so much fun, but why? Why? I didn't have any complaints. I didn't worry about anything. So why did I try to destroy everything myself?
I have no idea. Mr. Sniper.
Rena, you're awesome.
I don't trust it. I don't trust her. Nope. Don't trust it at all.
After I killed you and Mio, I didn't realize anything, so I left a note and called Oishi. But I still believed that everyone else was at fault. Until... I mean, even after I was dead. I didn't even realize my sin. How sad is it to kill my friends because of a little misunderstanding, even when they were trying to help me? And how painful is it was not to realize it was a sin. Yeah, I still don't believe her. Therefore, you're great, Rena. You didn't kill any of your friends.
You really wanted to?
Crazy psycho bitch. You came to your senses before you committed a sin.
She was that close. She had the lighter open. She was that close to killing 25 people. Don't act like she was like, you know,
Don't act like she wasn't far away from doing it. She was like a second away from killing 25 people and herself. No qualms about it. You're awesome, Rena. Just awesome. You're different. No, Mion is awesome. She's different because she'd never get to this point. Fuck both of you. Rena stands up slowly and lowers her hatchet, and then buries it in the cage's head.
I hurt my friend. I hurt Michan.
No, don't. No shit, you did. I'm pissed at that.
Just apologize to her.
Yeah, I'm sure it's okay.
She's just everyone's punching bag. I personally think the wounds will help me separate the sisters.
Okay, that's a really, really bad joke. Like, that's terrible. That is terrible. That's god-awful, Keiji. Fuck you.
I hope you fall off that building. I hope the building explodes.
Only killing you and Rena at this point.
I've already killed.
Huh?
No, you haven't.
Yes, she has. Who'd you kill? Those two other people?
Mami Arena and Hojo Tepe.
Ah, those two. Oops. Completely forgot.
I thought it was right to kill them. But the day I killed them, the world started to go crazy. The first one was okay. I give my seal of approval. In the law, that's okay. The second one, not as okay. Not as okay. That means, was it wrong to kill them? I don't know if it was right or wrong, but it wasn't the best thing you could have done. What do you mean by the best thing? Don't you know? I grab Rena's head and embrace her. Then tell her. I tell her something so simple. It's so simple anyone can think of it. But Rena didn't do it. I didn't do it either back then. If you're in danger, or you feel like doubting others, or something sad happens, go talk to Mion, because she brings up happiness everywhere. It was so simple. You talk to your friends. That's right. You're right. Oh.
Crying.
Rena cries in my arms for a while. She cries about the wrong choices she made in the very beginning. The choice couldn't have been hard to see. I'm sure it was something that was within her grasp. How stupid it was to worry about it by herself. She had friends. She had friends whom she trusted. Why'd she think she couldn't talk to her friends about it? I was wrong. Why didn't I talk about it? Everyone trusted me, so why didn't I trust them? I was the same way before. That's why I won't laugh at you. But you realized it. You realized it a lot sooner than I did. We will trust each other. We will never doubt our friends. We will rely on each other. We will talk to each other and will help each other out. That's why friends are always happy and we can endure anything together. Okay, Rena. Why don't we respond to the curtain call? It's really the end of everything. What do you mean by the curtain call? What do you mean?
Well, I was just talking to myself. Come on.
We stand up together, holding hands. The moon hangs behind us. When I nod, Rena throws the hatchet and disappears into the darkness below us. Then I speak to the audience in hell, the demons who weren't expecting this ending. I'm proclaiming victory. This is it for tonight. We defeated the tragedy. We will never doubt each other again. We'll be united always. No matter what kind of tragedy strikes, we don't ever think it will be daunted. Who cares about tragedy? Who cares about disaster? Even if we face an evil script, we will destroy it.
That's the end? What the fuck? What's this music? The hell?
This is some good music, though.
Oh, that's the end. Ugh. So everyone lives? I find that impossible to believe. Fuck off that everyone lived. Bated breath. She might be alive.
On June 25th, the suspect, Ryugu, broke into the Forest Service office. Forced away 25 people hostage. For over 7 hours, 1845, several hostages resisted, fled the building, blah blah blah. At 9:10, she agreed to disarm and surrender, freeing the final hostage. Casualties 4, all minor injuries, details.
Sonozaki Mion was captured by the suspect around noon that day, escaped, inflicted minor injuries on her while she was captivity. Rika, Satoko, Mayabara. He received minor injuries when he engaged in combat with the suspect. Regarding the arrest of Ryugu Rena, she disarmed and surrendered to the police at 9:10 and was subsequently arrested. She was taken to the Okinoya police station questioned. She admitted to the outline given above. Or below. There was some dispute about the accountability of the suspect during the crime, but after subjugating her to a psychic evaluation, the prosecution determined the suspect is fully accountable for her actions. RIP. The defense is in direct opposition to this and has submitted their own psychiatric examination report denying the suspect's accountability. The trial is currently in session. Interesting. Oh, this was actually a pretty good chapter. I'm not gonna lie. It was interesting. To be fair, I wouldn't have been. I would have skipped school once Chie left because that's just what I use. That's what I do. If I'm in high school, whenever a teacher wasn't in class, I left. Because what the fuck is keeping me in this class? What's keeping me here if I don't have to be here? So I would have left the second she left. So that would have been fine. I would have probably tried to convince Mion to go with me and leave, and maybe even Satoko and Rika and just say, hey, let's screw around in town or something. We have all day. Fuck it. That kind of thing. So I wouldn't have been in that situation. I also would have said, eh, fuck it. I'll take some children's lives. So those two things, I wouldn't have let her spread the gas because I would have tried to getting her off that in the first place, because that would have been, fuck that, worst case scenario. But all in all, it was a good chapter. I liked the answers that was giving me. Now it's a crazy amount of, I don't know what the fuck's going on. That there's definitely some magic bullshit, supernatural elements at play here that I'll have to go into. I'll probably come up with a video about a theory of what I think is going to happen, what I think is well, I can't have any possible of clue of what will happen, but I'll give my conclusion of what is happening, why it's happening, etc., etc. So I'll come up with that probably tomorrow. And, yeah. Everyone fucking lived for once. Thank God. Can we just call this like happy ending? Game over. We win. That's a happy ending, right? Mion's alive. She's happy. That's all I care about. Happy ending. Best chapter. I don't know what to know. She was pretty good. Scenario jump mode has been, yeah, whatever. Give me the behind the scenes developer thingy. That's what I want. Extra. Yep. Yeah, but everyone fucking lived. Hell yeah. Good ending. Do we not get like a post thing for that? Staff room. There you go. Do we not get like a little post thing? Like everyone happy life. Happily ever after. The end. That'd be nice. The demon script, a new tab. Might as well do that. Fuck it, why not? Extra. Oh god. Oh, there's only two pages. Demon script. 17th year of the Heisei era. Heisei? 2005. Really far in the future, actually. The car begins to rattle as the road turns from asphalt to gravel. The cry of the cicadas seeps through the shut windows. Most people would open their car windows and let the natural air in along with the sounds of the cicadas. Depends how hot it is outside. But people are also spoiled. He'd rather keep himself cool with the air conditioning, turn to max, and then listen to the cicadas. Probably Oishi. Usually it's the rainy season at this time of the year.
But this year, the summer has already come in June without any rain. Just like how the weather was on that day, 20 years ago. The air around this area is still as clear as I remember it. Yeah, the winds and the sunshine here are nice. This place could have been a UNESCO World Heritage Site, like the village in Gifu. What a waste. But thanks to that, there are no irritating tourists around here. See, it makes it much better. Why do tourists forget about pedestrian traffic laws when they're in rural areas? They walk in the middle of the road and, you know? Akasaka, do you still do outdoor activities? Oh, Akasaka. Oh, dude, I've missed you. Not as much as I used to. My job didn't give me much free time. Huh. Same here. Oh, hey. There he is. The other man notices and waves his hand before he can honk his horn. The man is a young fellow on a motorcycle with his big backpack on his shoulders. He looks like he's ready to camp out. Fucking Keiichi? Did he turn into Tometake? Akasaka and his partner step out of the car and shake hands with the young man. It's nice to see you again, sir. Yo, how's everything going? Here at ease. This is Akasaka. He took care of me back in college. Hello, my name is Akasaka. Oichi was supposed to come today, but he had to go for a medical checkup at the last minute and wasn't able to come today. Anyway, it's a pleasure to meet you. It's an honor, sir. So, Akasaka, where shall we go first? His name is Akasaka Mamoru. He's a veteran police detective from the Tokyo Metropolitan Police Department. I'm very familiar with Akasaka from one chapter. He's a cool dude. I liked him. Despite the fact that he's close to his retirement, he hasn't lost his sharp and stinking eyes at all. His eyes show the confidence he's built through many risky experiences, and he has the well-built muscular body and a fearless aura. He must have fought against violent crimes. His connection to Hinamizawa goes back almost 30 years, to the 53rd year of the Showa era. He was the Public Safety Division in the Metropolitan Police Department. He came to Hinamizawa to investigate the kidnapping case of the grandson of Inugai, the then-time Minister of Construction. There he met Oishi and Furude Rika. Furude Rika predicted the fate of her own death. Akasaka regrets to this day that he couldn't save the girl from her fate. God damn it. He saw the news of the Hinamizawa disaster on TV and met up again with Oichi. Fuck me. God damn it. Can me own police have survived it for once? Once, please. Please. I already know where they're going. Please. They pledged to uncover the mystery of the cruel fate that fell upon the little girl in the series of mysterious deaths in Hinamizawa. Unfortunately, Hinamizawa was sealed off for a long time. As a result, all Akasaka and Oishi could do for the past 20 years was to publish the little information they had gathered, and ask for the readers to send their tips and clues. But the seal of Hinamizawa was finally opened. However, they couldn't come to Hinamizawa until today due to Akasaka's busy work schedule and Oishi's poor health. In fact, Oishi was supposed to come with Akasaka today, but he was called in for an emergency health checkup, so Akasaka was the only one to come here today. The other two who came along are Akasaka's juniors from his university, one who works at the ground SDF, and the other is his subordinate. They were assigned to the seal-off mission of Hinamizawa, so they were quite knowledgeable about the village. Akasaka takes out a scrapbook from his bag. The corners of the scrapbook are all dented, and I can tell it's very old. Akasaka flips through the pages, thinks for a second, and tells us the first stop. Alright, please take me to the Onigafuji swamp first. No problem. Right this way, sir. The young man gets on his bike and waits for the others to get back to the car. They honk at each other to signal that they're ready, and the young man leads the car to the Onigafuji swamp. They go through the forest and come to an open area where the ground's covered by concrete. There's not even a single drop of water in sight. All the water of the swamp has been replaced by concrete. This is what the current Onigafuji swamp looks like. There's not even a single drop of water, let alone a swamp. I was told that they'd sealed the swamp right after the disaster. This place was already encased in concrete by the time I arrived here for my mission. Let's go down there and take a closer look. Akasaka gets out of his car and walks to the center of the concrete-filled swamp. It's not a parking lot or a heliport. It's just a huge empty concrete space right in the middle of the forest. So this is a place where people say was a landing spot for UFOs. Really, I've never heard of that. Well, that's what they wrote on occult websites. They said that this is the place where our government met with aliens. But I don't blame them for such rumors, because this empty concrete space in the middle of the forest does look pretty weird for sure. Volcanic gas erupted from the swamp in June of the 58th year of the Showa era. The deadly mixture of hydrogen sulfide and carbon dioxide engulfed and destroyed Hinamizawa in a single night. The village was sealed off and the SDF covered the swamp with concrete. But the people who write the rumors on internet actually have a point as well. Any geologist could tell you that the covering the source of the gas with concrete is absolutely useless. That's true, because it won't prevent a buildup. That's true, I've never heard of anyone trying to prevent a volcano from erupting by pouring concrete into its crater. On the other hand, our country is known for wasteful construction using taxpayers' money. Lately, people who love supernatural phenomena and UFOs write on the internet about the Hinamizawa disaster. It's well known by now that the cause of the Hinamizawa disaster was an eruption of deadly volcanic volcano from a magma crater. In the 61st year of the Showa era, a similar natural disaster occurred at Lake Neos in Cameroon, Africa. So people believe that such a rare natural disaster could occur anywhere on Earth, and that was what happened in Hinamizawa as well. However, a rumor about another possible explanation began to fly around the internet recently. They say that the Hinamizawa disaster was a cover-up by the government, that it was actually a biochemical terrorist attack by aliens. God, Takano, calm down. Why has such a rumor begun to spread now? They claim to back up their theory with the secret document known as File Number 34. Someone named it File Number 34 on the internet for descriptive purposes, but the name spread and stuck since then because it sounded like a government conspiracy and people loved it. It's unknown how or from where they obtained these documents, but they posted scans and pictures of the documents, which were all ridiculous. Plus, more fake evidence was produced over this time, so now, even the existence of such documents is in doubt. I'd like to explain more about File Number 34. However, since it started on the internet, truths and lies are all mixed up, and now it's more like an urban legend. Never believe everything you read on the internet, because it's the internet. So this is what I believe is mostly true. None of it. File Number 34 was a notebook written by a nurse named Takano Mio, who worked at a local clinic in Hinamizawa. Well, what a fucking surprise. File Number 34 was most likely named after her. This woman was a researcher who studied the demon myth of Hinamizawa and tried to solve what it meant. The contents of this notebook state that she prophesied the Hinamizawa disaster in the 58th year of the Showa era.
Yeah, I'm sure she did.
I doubt it. According to her research, she claims that a UFO landed in Hinamizawa a long time ago and sunk into Onigafuchi Swamp. Yeah, okay. The UFO carried parasitic bacteria from space and they began to infect the locals. The infected villagers began to behave extremely violently, so much that they were fit for the word demon. Takano Mio insisted that this was the explanation for the myth about demons pouring out of the swamp. An alien who survived the crash realized that Earthlings had gone crazy because of the bacteria he brought in, and he decided to show himself to the villagers to help them out.
Oh god.
Anyone who even remotely believes this is full of shit. This is how Oyashiro-sama was born. The alien was able to cure the villagers with highly advanced technology, but couldn't eradicate the bacteria completely. Since the villagers looked up to the alien as some sort of deity, the alien utilized its status to hand down a specific rule to the villagers in order to stabilize the disease. The bacteria took a liking to Hinamizawa's habitat, so when the carrier of the disease left Hinamizawa, the symptoms would reemerge. Which makes absolutely no sense, but sure, for that premise, let's say it does. Therefore, the alien made a rule not to leave the village. This leads to the legend of the hermits of the Onigafuchi village.
The weird parasites and miracles that hermits performed were realized by means of ancient technology that they received from the alien. God, the fucking aliens everywhere.
Haha, those maniacs do indeed have a colorful perspective on things like this, don't they? Do you remember Nostradamus' prophecy? People said that the world was going to end in 1999, but nothing happened in July, and people acted like they didn't even know about it. Those TV shows made people scared as much as they could, and then ignored the fact that it didn't happen. Of course, same with the Mayan calendar bullshit. Oh, it's gonna end, and what? 2013 was supposed to be the end, or 2012, the end of the world. Get the fuck out of here. It's all bullshit. Anyone claiming to know when any disaster is happening is full of shit. But Takanomiya did prophesize the Inamizawa disaster. If you know anything about geology, you could assume and surmise that there might be a disaster coming forward, whatever, blah, 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 blah. It's not a lie. And I can predict that there's gonna be an earthquake that destroys a city one day. Whoop-de-damn-do. Look at this page in the scrapbook. You must be joking. Akasaka, is this for real? As time passed, the bacteria stabilized in human bodies and became harmless. Oh my good god, shut up, Rena. Shut up, shut up, shut up. The alien and the bacteria began to fade away from people's minds. However, the alien has lived on for hundreds of years with the protection of the three families. It still lives as a spirit of a deity in the sacred temple of the Shrude Shrine. The alien manipulated the bacteria living inside of the villagers and maintained control over the village for hundreds of years. The alien wanted to regain its power and started researching how to bring back the lost powers of the bacteria. Blur, blur, blur. And things got much weirder from here. People will say that the Inamizawa disaster was actually part of the alien's plan to conquer the entire Earth by spreading the reawakened bacteria. The Japanese government has this secret division that fights against alien invasions. And they had training at Area 51 in the US, blah, 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 blah. And they moved in to stop the invasion by sealing off the entire village, and they killed all of the residents by using toxic gas. I doubt it, but whatever. Ha! Hey, there's a movie that's just like that. Some black guy's the lead character. What was the title? Am I some... Oh my good god. Yeah, I know. It's too crazy to be real. But the writer of this is a bunch of bull. Takanomiya was mysteriously murdered in June 5th of the 58th year of the Showa. Right before her death, she gave her scrapbook to a girl, as if she knew she was going to die very soon. The girl is known as Girl A. Seems like a guy who investigated the case was able to track it down to a girl named Ryugu Reina. So now it's known as the Ryugu Reina theory on the internet. Ryugu Reina inherited Takanomiya's scrapbooks, Mio's will by means of the scrapbooks. She tried to fight against the planned invasion by holding a school hostage and demanding the local police uncover the alien's plot. Of course, no one believed her and they assumed she was in a state of paranoia. She was. Back then, people assumed that Ryugu Reina took Takanomiya's delusion seriously and was motivated to commit a poorly executed crime. She did. When she held the school hostage, Ryugu Reina told the school that the alien was controlling the three families, and that it was plotting massive bioterrorism. And the very next day, the Inamizawa disaster occurred. You've gotta be kidding. Couldn't it be just a coincidence? Probably. I don't know. According to the people who believe it's not just a coincidence, there are many inconsistencies in the immediate seal-off by the SDF. Filling the swamp with concrete is one example. According to some of the SDF members who were on the seal-off mission at the time, they witnessed that some people conducted some kind of secret research unrelated to the normal geological research. Bullshit. Of course, those who think it's just a coincidence say that the researchers simply took precautionary measures to keep unauthorized people out of the area. Obviously. I'd have to agree with the latter people. People also question why they sealed off the village for such a long time. The seal-off of the Miyake Island for the volcanic gas lasted only 4 to 5 years. The natural disaster of Inamizawa was exceptionally rare, yet the seal-off lasted for over 20 years. Heard that the residents of Miyake Island returned to their home islands faster than was originally intended, because they made a strong appeal. But in the case of Inamizawa, there were no residents alive who wished to return to the place. Perhaps the government took their time until they were absolutely certain that it was safe. How about this one? The SDF members who were on the Seawalk mission in Hinamizawa had their blood samples taken periodically. Some of them were discharged from the mission without any explanation after the results came back. Some believe they were using the members of the SDF as human test subjects to see if they got infected or not. No, probably just to check like their sulfur levels to see if they're fucking dying. I think they were just checking up the members' health condition since they were in the area where the gas disaster occurred. Besides, normal businessmen also take annual physical checkups, and they have their blood samples taken there as well. Yeah, I understand your point too, but I have another interesting theory. Oh god, fucking shut up. There are some people who believe that there was no gas emitted during the so-called Hinamizawa disaster. No volcanic gas? What does that mean? Basically, what they're saying is that there was no volcanic gas and it was some sort of government cover-up. It's like the movie made by Steven Spielberg, you know, the one where humans make contact with UFOs. Heck, this is exactly what I call a typical example of maniac's way of explaining things. What kind of basics do they have to say that there was no emission of basis do they have to say that there was no emission of volcanic gas? Well, a bunch of maniacs came to Hinamizawa as soon as the seal off was opened. According to them, the hydrogen sulfide in the volcanic gas would have caused some corrosion to metallic objects and major damage to the wildlife. However, they found no such signs of disruption, which led them to claim that there was no volcanic gas to begin with. But this village was abandoned for 20 years. Any dead plant would regrow in 20 years' time. I doubt they could find anything anyway. Well, that's the thing with the internet. You can't believe everything on it. Akasaka, please don't tell me you're buying these stories. I will be so disappointed in you, Akasaka. At first, I didn't. But lately, I'm beginning to think there might be some truth to them. Get the fuck out, Akasaka. Get the fuck out. You believe in UFOs? Oh, come on. Well, what if this scrapbook is the real file number 34? Huh? This scrapbook is the one that Ryugu Reina possessed when she took the school hostage on the 25th, in the 58th year of the Showa. It was assumed to be lost during the confusion of the Hinamizawa disaster, but Oishi's old friend was able to locate it in evidence storage at the prefectural police headquarters. Back then, Oishi thought Ryugu Reina was delusional, but after reading this again, after the Hinamizawa disaster, some of the contents seemed to hold vital clues. It's not the alien part that was interesting, but her theory that an endemic disease of parasitic microbes in Hinamizawa was the curse of Oyashiro-sama. Of course, there's no proof that such microbes existed, so it still remains at a theoretical level. Oishi says that the three families might have been researching how to bring the deadly microbe in order to bring back the religious devotion the villagers used to have. But there's no point to it. No one gains from it. The Hinamizawa disaster could be an experiment that went wrong. That's stupid. His theory is also based on the theories the myths have found on the internet. The village clinic's chief doctor died mysteriously right before the Hinamizawa disaster. Girl Furude Rika was brutally murdered on the night Ryugu Reina took the school hostage. There was an underground research lab beneath the village clinic, and Dr. Iro was forced to do biological research. But he couldn't live with his own sins and committed suicide. There was actually a lab underneath there? Furude Rika was brutally murdered as a sacrifice of some sort of ritual ceremony in the name of Oyashiro-sama's revival. However, their experiment went wrong. Instead of the microbes being parasitic in the villagers, it became a killer virus. And it exterminated the entire village in one night. But it wouldn't make sense if people who didn't have the disease inside of them got it. Like, Keiichi wouldn't die. Because he wasn't born in the village. He wouldn't have had the disease to begin with, unless it's in the air. It's so obvious that it wasn't a simple gas disaster. We cannot ignore the fact that one girl prophesied bioterrorism right before the gas disaster, and that several villagers died mysteriously, including Takanomiya herself, who wrote about all that in the scrapbook. It doesn't sound right to say that Hinamizawa disaster was an unpredicted and coincidental natural disaster. When you read this file number 34, it's obvious. So you're saying that
Hinamizawa disaster wasn't a rare natural disaster, but that it was in fact an act of bioterrorism for some cultist. In the Heisei era, everyone in Japan knows about the shocking incident of a doomsday cult group that created nerve gas, sarin, and unleashed it to kill people. Or sarin. Whatever. But in the Showa era, the idea of a single cult group being able to carry out an act of terrorism didn't even cross our minds. Some also say that the reason why the SDF sealed off the area for such a long time was due to the intensive research project to find the killer virus, but I'm not convinced about that. At least the story sounds more convincing than the one with the aliens and UFOs. The idea of cultists and domestic terrorism, that sounds more rational. Maybe there really wasn't a UFO that crash-landed. When Ryuga Rena took the school hostage, one of her demands to the police was to have them pull out the wreckage of the UFO from the Onigafuchi Swamp. That's ridiculous. Well, even if I wanted to make sure if it's ridiculous or not, look at it. The swamp is filled with concrete several meters thick and there's no way that you can check. This all because of that ridiculous construction that doesn't even do anything to prevent the volcanic gas. Well then, the only way to prove Akasaka's theory is to find a survivor of Hinamizawa and try to find that microbe in him or her. Sadly, that's almost impossible. After the Hinamizawa disaster, some survivors were subject to a witch hunt. So even if there are survivors, they won't tell you that they're from Hinamizawa. Right after the Hinamizawa disaster, some people who are from Hinamizawa started showing erratic behavior. When they started dying mysteriously and committing suicide in strange ways, people got scared of them and witch hunted them to get rid of them from their neighborhoods. The government was practically useless in protecting their privacy at the time, so the former residents of Hinamizawa lied about where they were from and have to keep it that way since. In that case, it's a dead end. But it's my duty as a cop to keep trying. There is much circumstantial evidence to say that the Hinamizawa disaster wasn't a natural disaster. If I can grab a hold of one piece of concrete proof, I think it can start reeling in the truth behind all of this. Yeah, but it's been over 20 years. The truth might be lying somewhere very deep in the darkness. That's true, I might not find any answers. It's already the 21st century. What happened in Hinamizawa in June of the 58th year of the Showa era? The only factual evidence that I have is that Takano Mio mysteriously died and left her scrapbook prophesying a bioterrorist attack. Young girl took a school hostage to make people listen to the prophecy, but no one took it seriously. The chief doctor of the village clinic committed suicide. People believed that a little girl, Furude Rika, was a reincarnation of Oyashiro-sama, and she was brutally murdered. What is the truth behind this scrapbook? What is written to reveal a huge conspiracy? Or is it just a bunch of delusions written by a maniac? If the contents of this scrapbook are true, the disaster could have been avoided if we had heeded the warnings of one girl. If they aren't true, then who created the disaster to follow the scenario of the scrapbooks? After the sarin nerve gas incidents, the words mind control came into the spotlight. In contrast to brainwashing, which can easily force a person to commit certain acts in a short term, mind control takes a long time to gradually make a person believe that what he or she must do is the right thing to do and act upon it as if it was his or her own actions. It's a form of character altercation, which is far more serious than brainwashing. The cult group induced fear and anxiety to its members through revelations of doomsday. At the same time, they ordered them to be certain things as a mean ordered them to do certain things as a mean of means of salvation, and made them do so voluntarily. The formula is quite similar to how Ryugu Reina became a puppet of file number 34. So does that mean Ryugu Reina was mind controlled by someone, probably Takano? Does that mean that the cult group that mind-controlled her tried to cause the end of the world in order to appeal the credibility of their teachings, just like the other cult group did? Actually, it's possible that Takano probably did something fucking stupid. Or, like, because she obviously influenced Tomei Take to believe whatever bullshit she was spewing to her and made Rena believe in the bullshit, Keiichi. So she's very persuasive.
She probably convinced someone with some form of power to do something. And then it probably just spiraled out of control from there. But I think it was a natural disaster, though. I mean, it's a natural fucking disaster. Does it make vial number 34 some sort of religious textbook for them? When I lose my grip of what's true and what's not, it sometimes makes me feel that someone might be laughing in amusement at this disaster. I doubt that. This scrapbook is like a script. It's a stage script of a tragedy that takes the lives of thousands of villagers in one night. It's a script for demons who enjoy the loss of human life. Someone wrote the script. Someone performed it. Someone watched the show and laughed. Damn it. What the hell happened in Hinamizawa in June of the 58th year of Showa? Higurashi when they cry. God damn it, I was hoping for actually a happy end, but no, everyone died. Damn it. Time for staff room and then we'll wrap it up. Hello, my name is Ryukishi07. I hope you enjoyed playing Higurashi When They Cry, Tsumihoroboshi. There are several themes I wanted to write in this chapter, but I'd like to talk about one of them here. Delusions? It's about denial of murder. Okay. There's something I had to write sooner or later, since this is a novel about serial murders. There are two means that especially youngsters use these days to solve problems, which are murder and suicide. When we feel stressed, we choose to either get rid of the source of stress or to get away from it. Let's say you're bullied by a kid at school. You beat the shit out of that kid. You have two ways to solve the problem. You choose either to get rid of the kid from this current environment or to get away from the environment. You beat the shit out of that kid beating the shit out of you. Usually, bullies are stronger and have their posse, so you don't stand a chance alone to get rid of them. Meh. You'd be surprised. If you stand up to them, they'll probably most likely leave you alone. That's how it worked for me. It's also not easy to switch classes or to quit school, so you can't easily get away from that situation. As a result, the situation gets worse day by day, and the stress urges you to solve the problem immediately. And you come up with murder or suicide as easy solutions. If suicide is considered defeat, you'd want to consider murder. I feel like there are many people who think that way. However, if you actually committed a murder, it wouldn't be easy to pay for the sin. Well, you'd go to jail. At least in the American law statutes, most likely. They'd try you as an adult and kill you. Well, not kill you, but throw you in jail. I believe murderers know that well, too. But you really hate the bully who pushed you to the limit where you have no choice but to kill the bully. So with a determination that turns your entire life upside down, you commit murder. But if you have such a strong determination, there have to be more ways to take than opting for murder, the last resort. You can talk to your friends. If that doesn't work, you can talk to your family, talk to your teachers, talk to a principal. Like, there's a lot of steps you take before you kill someone. If that doesn't work, you can talk to your teacher. If that doesn't work, then what? There has to be more ways. If you have the determination to give up on your life by committing murder, there have to be more ways. The Heisei era is better than any era before it. There are many hotlines that you can call to talk to someone. Hell, any era or any time period is always better than the last one, objectively. Well, not always objectively. It's usually better. Even if you don't have any friends or family, there are many places you can go for help. The people who answer the phone aren't amateurs. They're volunteers, but they're also veterans who have worked as social workers or counselors for juveniles for a long time. I can assure you that they have more social experience and passion than your parents. People who work to help people for free can't be bad people. True. If you feel like you have no choice but to kill the boy or to commit suicide, please try to call those hotlines. People who think it's useless to talk to others usually haven't really talked to anyone. Exactly. Oh, there's so many other solutions. Suicide is never the answer. Never. Never the answer. Never is. There's not one case where that is the answer. Unless the question is,
What is never the right solution to your problems? Suicide. That's the only time it's the answer. Have the courage to call. There will be someone who can completely rely on at the other end of the line. Don't keep it to yourself, talk to someone. Ryukishi wrote such a long story just to tell you this. He must have a very, very poor literary talent.
Yeah. Yeah, okay, buddy.
So Ryukishi wants to talk to you all rather than worrying all by himself. What should I do to write funnier and better stories? Huh. 07th expansion. Ryukishi, 07. Hey, stories are fine by me, buddy.
You have my stamp of approval, and that's all you need in your life.
But with that, I can soundly say that I am officially done with this chapter and on to the next one. But I have to thank you guys for watching so much.
Oh, I love this. This is a good chapter. I like
the dual aspects of the crazy and the not crazy. I love that. A lot of crazy shit went down. I'm looking forward to the next chapter. I'm interested to see what answer arc that responds to. But anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. I'm loving the series. I hope you guys are enjoying it as well. I mean, it seems like a lot of people are enjoying it. Subscriber numbers have gone up. View numbers have gone up. I love it. Can't ask for more. Up to 28 now. Shout out to you 28 people. Hey, that's impressive. I love it. But thank you guys so much. I can never thank you guys enough. Make sure to hit up the Discord app. I'm always on there usually. Ask me any questions you feel like. Rant about something, I'll answer your questions. I'll answer your problems. Because it's, I don't know, I like talking to you guys. There's not one time where I'll say, oh god, I hate talking to people. No, I love talking to people. It's interesting. At least that's how I view it. But anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. I'm going to go to sleep now. And then probably make my theory video in a little bit. And then go on to the next chapter. Man, that's going to be exciting. Anyways, thank you for watching. Don't want to ramble any longer. See you next time.